I'm going to start from scratch and then I may jump over to another example to show you. But how this works is exercise band, United States start session. Now, as I previously mentioned, the question that we're answering or what we're trying to achieve here is to out-optimize our competitors in terms of their listing and rank on page one. Two elements to the listing optimizer tool. The left one being obviously the keywords that we just collected. So I go to keywords, I go to add. Import from keywords on fire. And here you can see these are all my keywords that I have saved from keywords on fire tool. So I pick the most appropriate one. I want the strong and medium keywords and load them up, or you can go all. So those are my keywords. They're on the left-hand side. I know what keywords I want to create my listing of. Step number two here represents where I can create a listing. So I would click here and say, I'm going to show two examples. If you were to start from scratch, so say I'm just about to launch, I'm creating my skeleton listing, you can do it here. And then I'm going to show you if you already have an existing listing and you want to make, you're reviewing it and wanting to make changes. So here I can go to blank listing. I'll just write tester here, add. So here is all the aspects of Amazon listing. We've got title, we've got bullet points, we've got description, and we've got back-end search terms there. So all of that is there, and you can start creating a listing. However, there are two really powerful aspects of this tool, and I'm actually going to move over to another window that's already started. Mm-hmm. So there are two major, really amazing aspects of this tool. The first one being is that you can actually add your competitors' ASINs into this tool and directly compare your listing to your competitor's listing. So let's do that. I've already added these three ASINs here. So when you add an ASIN, this is what it comes up with. So the ASIN that I just added is all of this information. So from title, bullet points to description, but more importantly, now I actually have access to the backend search terms of that competitor's ASIN, which is obviously really powerful to have that. So you can add up to eight ASINs here. I've got three. And actually in this example, I'm going to pretend that this is my ASIN. So this is my current ASIN that's live. This is my current listing. And now I'm reviewing my listing. How is it compared to my other competitors? So compared to these other two top competitors, what are we comparing? We're comparing this optimization score. And this optimization score is a strength of the, or calculated by the strength of the keywords used and where they are placed. So this score, based on all my keywords, as you can see, when you roll through here, you can see where I've used the keywords. This also gives an indication of where the keywords are used. So this star is an exact match in the title, a broad match in the title, a tick is included in the listing. And if there's no star, it means that that phrase hasn't been used in the listing. So you get an indication of where all these are used, but then we've got this score. So my ASIN has a score of 25,000. This competitor has a score of 24,000 and this one has a score of 26,000. So if I'm here, I'm just like, okay, well, my listing is okay compared to my competitors, but I still have this listing that is doing better. And when I say doing better, it means that they are utilizing keywords in their listing in a better way than I am. So let's have a look what they're doing. So as I said, you can scroll through, see what order they're using their keywords. Do they have more stars here? Are they using more in the title versus their listing, for example? And what are they doing in their backend search terms? So then you can go over to your listing and make some changes. Now, when you make changes here, it's not changing on Amazon, it's just changing here. So you can edit and play. You can do it over periods of days. It will save on here, so you don't have to worry about that. But I want to show you how easy it is to make changes. So my ASIN, my optimization score is 25,000. This is my title. And I'm going to delete this title and paste a new one that I have created earlier based on only the keywords on the left-hand side. So I'm pasting that in. And this recalculates immediately. Oh. So I've gone from 25,000 to 32,000. So very quickly, we all know that your title is, Amazon doesn't say, but your title is your most expensive or most important bit of real estate that you have on your listing. You need to have the most impactful, relevant keywords in the title. And that's what I've done by knowing what keywords actually needed. And I've already able just to bump it there. And then leaving, or, you know, everyone has their own way of how they like to create their bullet points and their description. I personally focus on the keywords in the title and the bullet points, an opportunity to more so educate about my product, what are benefits, the features, giving them content and value of why they need my product in their life, rather than cramming it with keywords, because my title has taken care of that. So that's how the listing optimizer tool is. Now, if you go over to the left-hand side here, you can see that I don't have anything in my description or my search terms. So I would continue building out my listing. But what you can do in your backend search terms, say that I have created my listing. It's perfect. I love everything about it. There's the keywords that are left over. So the keywords that are in green means that I have not added that word in my listing. So what you can do is by clicking on it, it's automatically added to your backend search terms. Here, they're coming up. Your score continues to grow. So, you know, you want to add, if there's no other words that you want to add there, why not add these ones if people are still using it? So as you can see, my score continues to grow. We also give an indication of search volume. So out of all these keywords, this is the max possible search volume that you can take advantage of. So 1.5, I've utilized 1.1. Here is revenue. So total combined revenue for all these keywords are 17.5 million. I'm optimized for 13.3 million. So you can keep on doing until you hit it all. And then once you know that your score is the highest you can possibly make it, you've out-optimized your competitors. So out-optimized your competitors, best listing, and increased your chances of ranking on page one. Because your ZonGuru account is connected to your Amazon Seller Central account, you can click here and you go publish on Amazon. It'll give you, it'll redirect you to your Seller Central account. You can pick the ASIN that you want to edit. So it eliminates a lot of like the downloading of flat files, exporting, et cetera, a lot of fluff from that end as well. So that is the listing optimizer tool with keywords on fire. As I said, I believe great. I hate the term game changer, but I think it eliminates a lot of hardship really from when people don't really understand what they're supposed to be doing when it comes to creating a listing. But there's a difference between creating a listing and optimizing a listing. And this helps you create an optimized listing.
Yeah, I mean, it's easy to understand. It shows you what keywords are in the best-selling products. And you need to pick, of course, not necessarily the best-selling, the most relevant products in your niche. So we take only the most relevant, put them inside, see where they're ranking, what they're missing, and we try to just in our listing have everything that they're missing that they have as well, so we can have it as optimized as possible. And these three lines, the optimization score, search volume, combined revenue, they help us understand it. And on the left, it will show us if we have the keyword or not. So we click on them, it adds them up. So the way we do it in our business, we try to essentially have all the relevant keywords. Title is, as we also believe, the strongest one, because also most of the people will read the title. Maybe not as many people will read the bullet points in the description. So, but we still place all the keywords and we try to have all the relevant ones better than the competition. Of course, for the title and the bullet points, with a well-built way, so it's readable and maybe exciting even. Like, that's also cool. Plus, we add the image, but that's another story. But yeah, for SEO optimization, pretty cool. I mean, easy to understand and easy to implement, seems to be, yeah.
I agree with all of the above. And it's a very, what I do like about the tool suite is very easy, intuitive to use. There's no trapdoors or hidden things. Everything that you need is there. The things that you don't need are removed. They're not there.
Cool.